واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. سبحانك لا نحصي ثناءً عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله على ما أنعمت وأوليت يا رب العالمين. اللهم كما أنعمت فأدم وزدنا من نعمك واجعلنا من الشاكرين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله أرسله رحمة للعالمين وهدى وبشرى للمحسنين فبلغ رسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. وصل اللهم عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته واقتفى أثره بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز: يريدون ليطفئوا نور الله بأفواههم والله متم نوره ولو كره الكافرون. Allah the Almighty says in His book, they want to extinguish the light of Allah, but Allah will complete His light even though the disbelievers dislike it. From this very verse, we can see that Allah Azza wa Jalla is highlighting the fact that whenever we have the truth, it has enemies around it. Whenever we have the truth, we have many challenges around it. They try and try and keep trying till the last minute. And unfortunately, this is what we have seen throughout our history today until the Day of Judgment, an ongoing challenge. The most difficult challenge is in your deen, in your religion, the code which connects you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rope which connects us with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whoever clings hard to this rope, he will be saved. And whoever leaves it, he will bear the consequences of his choice. So since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the prophets and messengers with the truth, to deliver the truth, to judge amongst people with justice, they have been faced with many enemies. And after the prophets and the messengers, we have the representatives of the prophets and the messengers. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-ulama warathatul anbiya. The scholars are the heirs of the prophets. So they will be facing sort of the same challenge. Enemies, plots, cunnings, you name it. And our enemies are very shrewd. and I know where to strike. Because if you were to destroy the authority, the religious authority, you destroy the deen. So you can't go and attack directly the Quran or directly the Sunnah, although it's been happening since Orientalism started. Anyway, it's fading now. But nevertheless, still the case. You cannot directly go and face this very challenge against Quran or against the Sunnah. Instead, they choose a different path. They will sometimes create a character, a figure in the community which claims it's a person of knowledge, and this person carries already a distorted knowledge deliberately or sometimes with ignorance. And this will be one of the challenges which we have, the misrepresentation. They will be delivering fatwas left, right, and center, Islamic opinions left, right, and center, under the name of Islam, until many people in the community, especially our youth, will disagree with this, and sometimes will be deluded and follow it, and sometimes will go against it completely, and not only this, but will go sometimes, unfortunately, against Islam, because of this distortion and deformation of religion. When you read the Quran, it's not a new challenge. وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِي ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. When Allah stated in Surah Al-Baqarah, was addressing the people of the book, do not exchange my revelation with a cheap price. Do not commercialize the religion. Do not make your religion your source of living, i.e. a business. Similarly, although the Quran here is mentioning tashtaru and yashtaroon in many verses, which is an expression of exchange. And this is one of the opposite words in Arabic. We use shtara for selling and we use shtara for buying. The same word, depends on the context. So don't sell your deen and don't exchange it for something which is cheap. Don't do that. Be a person of the truth. You've been honored by carrying this truth. So you have to stand up and defend it. So we've seen this throughout the history of humanity. It's not a challenge which has been faced by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No, no, no. All prophets and messengers, they almost face the same challenge. Those, even sometimes people around prophets and messengers will do something like that. Of course, not the sincere ones amongst them. So since the challenge started, since Shaytan declares his promise to Allah that he will distort and deform as much as possible and whisper as much as possible, the challenge is ongoing. And today is not different than yesterday, actually. It's the same. You go and look around you. You will find, especially after what's the so-called the Arab Spring, many imamas collapsed, and many scholarship collapsed, and many dignified people became undignified people. Just the veil has been dropped. The masks already been revealed. And and taken away. You see the real person behind that mask. If it's saying anything, it's just confirming the reality of the challenge which Allah stated in the Quran. They want to extinguish the light of Allah, but they can't. So we need to be very careful. And within this very country as well, we've seen some support and some figures in the community misrepresenting the Muslim community, be it supported by the government, supported by some politicians, you name it. And this is why, again, we learn from our history. When you read the history, you will find a similar or semi-divorce between governments and scholars throughout our history. You find some exceptions, but almost all the respected scholars divorced the government. They were not working to support the government. They are neutral, not on their payroll. Neutral scholars are always the best recipe for success. But those who are working for this governor or that president or this institute, they might, and many times, distorted Islam. And unfortunately, we've seen many of these in today's time. Alhamdulillah, people are still clear about what is the truth, but sometimes it's confusing. You find a big imama or long beard and he's just delivering something just to justify why this ruler is killing his people. What on earth are you doing? Or to justify why he's smashing people in demonstrations. Or to justify why he's putting loads in prisons. Or why he is kicking people outside his country. And you name it. If you want to do this, do it under your name. Don't do it under our name, under our religion. Say, this is my opinion. Don't say, this is what Islam says. This is from Sharia point of view. Don't say this. Because people will hate Islam through these fatwas and use it as a weapon against us. And some of our youth even will hate Islam when they see Islam is just defending oppression and supporting oppressors. I can assure you, this is not in any shape or form an Islamic version of Islam. This is a deformed, this is distorted version of Islam. It has nothing to do with Islam at all. And we've seen in this country again some foundations, organizations, institutes supported by the government to represent the Muslim community. And unfortunately, they are just spreading in every event. Fatwas here and fatwas there, just to approve what the government wants. Exactly, 100%, because it's being funded by the government. What's that? It doesn't represent any one of us. So we need to be very clear that the truth lies in the Quran and the Sunnah, and the truth lies with those who are really committed to this message. Not committed to their bank account, not committed to what position they will receive, and not committed to what it will benefit them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran to warn our community, ourselves, that You will be faced by many challenges, but you have to be careful. The light of the truth is very bright, like the sunlight, and even more. So don't be deceived by these people. Don't be deceived by these, might be popular people even. Don't. Ibn al-Mubarak narrated in his book Az-Zuhd, and Imam al-Tirmidhi in his book As-Sunan, and Ibn Hibban in his book As-Sahih, that Aisha once, radiallahu ta'ala anha, received a book from Muawiyah. He sent her a letter when he was a governor in Sham. He said, "Awsini wa aqili." Give me a piece of advice, but make it short. Don't make it long. And Aisha responded, radiallahu ta'ala anha, radiallahu ta'ala anha. She said, "Salamun alayk. إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من اشترى رضا الله بسخط الناس رضي الله عنه وأرضى عليه الناس ومن اشترى رضا الناس بسخط الله سخط الله عليه وأسخط عليه الناس." So she said, "I've heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, whoever seeks to please Allah by doing something which displeasing people, Allah will be pleased with him and the people will be pleased with him. And whoever seeks to please people by displeasing Allah, Allah will be displeased with him and the people will be displeased with him." And salamun alaykum. Finish. This is her advice to Umar, radiallahu ta'ala, to Muawiyah, sorry. So, as you can see, very straightforward. We are seeking Allah's pleasure. We should not seek the government's pleasure if they were on the wrong. We should not seek anyone's pleasure if he's on the wrong. We seek Allah's pleasure always, because this is where the truth lies. You won't get it wrong. This is your compass. This is your direction. Wherever the truth lies, follow it. It's like your Qibla direction, navigator Qibla to find your direction to pray. Find your direction in life by following the truth. Not to be deceived by any person who's claiming that he is following the truth. We judge people according to the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's not the other way around. We don't judge the truth through people. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن بعده وخلف. We already identified the problem almost. What is the solution? The solution is to learn the truth from authentic sources, from authentic, reliable authorities. How do we know that he is authentic, he is reliable? Everyone knows. You can easily ask, you can Google him, you can ask those whom you trust their knowledge and their piety and their understanding of reality. It's not enough to be a person of knowledge of the books. We have to be as well a person of knowledge of reality. To marry the two together, and this is where you can deliver the right opinion. Otherwise, it will be not possible to have the right side. It will be just excluded from reality. So we need independence as well. Scholars should always be independent. They should not follow this body or that body. Neutral, no one is controlling them. And this is why throughout our history we used to have something which we call Waqf al-Ulama, a special endowment for the scholars to keep their independence. They are not paid by the governor, they are not paid by the ruler, they have their own Waqf, so they can control their own opinions which represent the truth, inshallah ta'ala. So we need to create as well such endowments for the scholars to secure their independence and secure the future, inshallah ta'ala. And the second thing, we should not politicize our deen. Although our religion has some says in different occasions, that's fine. But we should not commercialize or politicize the deen. Just keep it neutral. The third thing which I want to say, it's Rajab now, and this is one of the prohibited months, or Ashur al-Hurum. And the Prophet ﷺ used to say, although it's a bit weak narration, but nevertheless, it's fine to narrate it in Fada'il al-A'mal, the virtues of good deeds. He used to say, ﷺ, in the opening of Rajab, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, bless us in Rajab and in Sha'ban and bring us to Ramadan. So let's roll up our sleeves and increase our siyam in preparation for Ramadan. To hit Ramadan with full speed, we need to start now preparing ourselves, our families, fasting Monday, Thursday, and as much as possible increase our recitation to the Quran, inshallah ta'ala. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept from all of us our good deeds. Amen. Allahumma ya Rabbi ya Rahman. Ya Badi'a al-Samawati wal-Ardh. Ya Dhal Jalali wal-Ikram. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna. Wa ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna. Wa ma anta a'lam bihi minna maulana rabbal alameen. Farij al-karba an al-maklubin. Wa nafis al-hamma an al-mahmumin. ووفي الدين عن المدينين اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم إنا نسألك يا الله يا الله قيادة صالحة تقية تحترم بأمرك وتنهى عن نواهيك تأخذ بأيدينا لما فيه رضاك يا رب العالمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين واجعلنا نصيرين للحق يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم احفظنا بما تحفظ به عبادك الصالحين اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن علمنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن أحسن إلينا ولمن أسأنا إليه وصلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.